The Text Compose tool is used to create ADA-compliant Braille signage, which can be either Grade 1 or Grade 2 Braille. The choice of grade depends on what your job requires. Grade 2 Braille is the same as Grade 1, except that Grade 2 uses contractions. And newly added Unicode support now allows for expanded applications of Braille in international languages. Also, Unified English Braille is now supported, which reduces and simplifies the overall variations in Braille encoding systems for English. Included within GraveLab are a selection of clip art designs, which are typical of interior Braille sign layouts. From the GraveLab installation directory, choose Clip Art, ADA, to view the Braille clip art. In particular, these 18 clip art templates have been pre-configured for production and can be repurposed for similar jobs. Please note that the level of compliance should be set according to your specific requirements for tactile symbol placement and letter kerning. If you are in doubt about the level of compliance, then you need to consult your customer and/or confirm what is expected in your region. For example, let us open the Type 1A CDL file. In the layer viewer, we can review the components of this design, such as the Braille text object, i.e. the Braille dots, the tactile English lettering, a tactile symbol, and a rectangle shape that defines the sign border. As a demonstration, suppose that you need a custom design that is similar to what we have here. We have a replacement tactile symbol, and we need to change both the tactile English lettering and the Braille dots. Using guides, it is easy to position the tactile symbol. For the lettering, we double-click to edit, and we type the replacement text. Depending upon your required Braille compliance, use on-screen kerning to adjust the spacing between the tactile lettering, like so. Review the clipart templates to develop a sense for the amount of spacing that ADA guidelines consider suitable for distinguishing tactile characters. For the Braille, we double-click to edit, and in the Smart Bar, we click the Translate to from Braille button to reveal its English meaning. When typing the replacement text, note that we are using lowercase letters. In general, the ADA Act reserves uppercase letters for proper nouns, and all other characters should be lowercase. Having typed our replacement text, we click the Translate to from Braille button again. At the top left, the font list indicates the type of Braille font that is being used. However, perhaps the customer requires a different Braille font. Let us click the Translate to from Braille button to reveal the lowercase lettering. Next to the Translate to from Braille button, click the Braille Settings button. In the Braille Settings dialog, note here that the older version 5 through 9 Braille translation has been enabled by default, which gives you support for these languages, and here is your choice between Grade 1 and Grade 2 Braille. Now, if you disable the checkbox for using the older Braille translation, this means that you are using the latest Unicode support for international languages. We are using English Braille for this example, and the subset of Braille is set here, per the customer requirements. Click the Browse button to reveal the font filter controls. There are several Braille dot fonts to choose from. The most common Braille font would be the BR Punch font, which is machined using a rotary engraver. An exception would be the State of California, which requires extra space between the Braille dots. So for California, you would double-click the BR Punch CA font. For the other types of Braille fonts, descriptions are provided in the help file. For now, we can click OK to accept the Braille Settings dialog. And in the Smart Bar, click the Translate to from Braille button. And here we have our finished Braille layout. At this point, toolpaths are needed for machining the tactile symbol and lettering, and the Braille will be automatically interpreted when output to the machine.